First, like to start by congratulating this institution for being awarded the Best Industry Linked Management Institute by AICTE-CII. So congratulations to all of you. This is a proud moment for all the new youngsters who have joined this institute. You must be feeling very proud. I wish you to get many, many more such recognitions. I happened to come here, like your madam told me, in Feb somewhere. But before that, my association has been that we have been recruiting a lot of people from this institute. So I'm quite aware of that, and I have very, very fond memories of last time when I visited here, when Hiramatsu-san, Japanese ambassador, was here, former president Mr. Pranab Mukherjee was here. And that time also, I think, those who were here, I had told you that. Before I start my presentation, I want to make it very clear that I am not a teacher, I am not a preacher, and I am not your grandfather who has come here to teach you. I have come here to welcome you, because you have come to a very prestigious institute. And let me once again thank Mr. Bansal, who has invited me to have an interaction with you, because I promised him that, you know, I get a lot of energy when I meet the youngsters, so next time when your new session starts, you should invite me. So I have come self-invited here to share with a different set of things which I have used during my 3.5 decades of professional career. Well, I belong to a very small village, which is about 100 kilometers from here. And I live in Delhi with my mother, who's 91 years old. I have one daughter and a son. My son is also professional. He's from MBA from LBS, and my daughter is a doctor. My wife used to work in Delhi administration. Now she is a housewife. But last time, when I came, it was for a convocation ceremony. And this time, I was told it's an induction. So student having different set of expectations from this institute and future professional life. The basis of my talk is not going to be PPT. I would be happy if I can clarify any of your doubts in your mind, because you are going to start your new inning. My experience is the only gift I can share with the future corporate leaders like you. During these 3.5 decades, whether it was Americans or whether it was House of Tatas, but I also dealt with some of the Koreans, some of the Chinese, and now I am with Japanese. I can only tell you one thing common. A few mantras, I would say that, you know, which have, irrespective of the nationalities. So I'm going to share those mantras with you, which you may find in your journey successful when you actually move after doing your MBA, or you should remember during your course, might help you. And if it helps you in your corporate life, I will be very happy. You will probably read this book during your course, but I think I have found it very, very successful. My first mantra is, control your destiny or someone else will. Now, many of you would probably read this, Authority and Accountability. This book says a lot. This book talks about speed in deciding and speed in doing. This book talks about the do simple things exceedingly well. But I think authority and accountability are two pillars on which you will scale the heights of your professional career. You should now learn to face adversity from the scruff of the neck and defeat it. This person whom I'm talking about, Jack Welch, he ran the most successful American company, which was G. And as students, be proactive and not reactive to the environment. Very often I say this to my team wherever I work, and if we don't control our destiny, someone else will. Either it is our competition or the business environment. Second principle of phrase, if you can conceive it, you can create it. And if you can create it, you should do matrix management. Once you start measuring what you have decided, I think you will be very successful. At first place, when you actually see this, you might get a lot of criticism. Some may say it is stupid, it is illogical, but one needs to persevere. I think perseverance is very, very important. The truth is that you have the power to bring that idea to life. So the biggest obstacle between you and the prize is yourself. Every day one must learn the right habits and unlearn the wrong one. To the young students, I must say that the world outside is constant battlefield. And every day when you wake up, you have to fight the new battle. And my own experience has been with many, many companies and many, many years that if you think big, you normally end up doing big. So start thinking big. When you aim high, you normally end up achieving that. Back in 2010, when I joined Daikin, it was less than 300 crore company, almost 292 crore company. And we have seen many, many adversities. In 2010, there was tsunami in Japan. 2011, I think there was some floods in Thailand. In 2012, we had exchange issues. So some or the other adversities will come in life. So it is how you look at, you can look at glass half full or glass half empty. Today also, I think our country is facing a big, big challenge. If you look at when you go outside India, you see or you hear glass full, half full. And when you talk within India, probably everybody wants to talk that we have too many challenges. So I think all of you, as youngsters, you should always look at the opportunities, how we can convert adversity into advantage, rather than only keep quibbling that, okay, this is not right, that is not right, because future of this country is going to be in your hand. The third principle is extraordinary results are achieved by doing ordinary things. Though I see many times, many companies, and particularly with Japanese, my experience has been that they are very, very highly process-oriented people. And they do too much of detailing in everything what they do. But I have found it in my experience that, you know, if you do simple things exceedingly well, that is what I think in our culture it works. This is quite self-explanatory. You are young and you can change the way more easily. Start small and do simple things right. And believe you me, it has worked very well. And from the daily course to the biggest of the college assignment, do it right, do it with sincerity. And I follow this very religiously on my daily routine. There is a Japanese principle of gamba, which means that actual place. We as Japanese company follow the principle to perfection. The most important activity is to meet, understand, and get feedback from the actual market on the field. Market is business and business is market. Sounds very simple, but actually it is. But many of the companies overlook the importance of it. One of the biggest success factors in Daikin, in our understanding, is of the market. We just don't sit on our workstation and formulate strategies. We go to the market because everyone from top to bottom practices business is market and market is business. Another very, very important principle which we follow, which has been crucial in my career, is the power of communication. communicate. Never hesitate to communicate, be it upward or downwards, be it with your peers, colleagues, teachers, parents, because communication leads to clarity and clarity leads to instant actions. As humans, we have the magnificent ability to communicate in the different ways. As young leaders, you must learn to communicate with your teams in your victories and in losses in equal measures. You have the responsibility to learn from losses and share the secrets of your victories with your colleagues. Remember, there is no replica of hard work. And you need to have passion, you need to have perseverance, you need to have conviction. Because if you do not have guts, if you don't have gumption, if you don't have grits, I think everything which you see or whatever you see will look very tall. But if you carry these mantras with you, then things will look simple. Like I said that, you know, probably in your day-to-day books, you will learn or you will read many things, but there are few things which you should not forget. And that is what I try to summarize these four or five simple mantras for you. But your attitude really determines your altitude. Attitude is not what you think, but how you think. Also, if you start working with passion, I think you feel at leisure. I have worked in air conditioning industry to close to four decades now. And in many colleagues and business partners are now like my family. I firmly believe that people do business with people. Some of them I have known through three generations. And I think if what has been said in the introduction, I think my presence has coincided with growth and prosperity of that company, and I always give that reason of that success to the people, those who have been associated with me in different forms, at different level. What I am trying to say here is that when you have passion, your work becomes your family. Now don't get me wrong here. You should maintain a healthy work-life balance when you are overburdened with the work. After all, family and their blessings is all that we work for. And then last but not the least, I think I have said to you that sincerity and dedication. It is no surprise that bigger and more important decisions have to be done with utmost sincerity and honesty. I want to stress on that everyday acts that we perform without much interest and thought. That is where you need to change and be sincere. Even the smallest of actions, no matter how mundane or insignificant, have to be done rightly. So I think have that will, have that guts to conceive new and bold ideas. At first you will face many times the hurdles, but ultimately you will succeed. So with these words I will close my speech, and I would like that, you know, if I can have the interactive session which might help you in your day-to-day life. Thank you.
So my question is regarding ACs also. You are with air conditioning industry. The government is planning to set 24 degrees of AC in your country. And in Japan, they have set 28 degrees. So what are your thoughts on this?
Yeah, if you ask me the thoughts, sir, that Daikin is at a thought leadership, and we went and met Mr. R.K. Singh, and we insisted, and we have been the prime driver on that. Because I think there are two priorities today for the country. One is health, and the other is environment. So I think, and also skill development. So this has been mooted, and Daikin also has been awarded last year the highest energy efficiency. So on energy conservation, this was mooted by Daikin, and we have fully supported it. And industry is following that now. It's a very, very good initiative by the government. Because we waste so much of energy in halls, in cinema halls, in probably at the airports or all public large building where, you know, temperature is around 18 degree, 19 degree. That is not a good idea. Thank you very much.